Welcome to a new video from ELE-T12. Today I'm going to talk about the ELE-T12. This is the ELE-T12. The ELE-T12 is an active soldering station which standardly uses active T12 tips for the soldering iron. The soldering station has a maximum power of 72 watts and a temperature range of 200 to 480 degrees Celsius, which in combination with an active tip is more than enough for soldering, for example, thick cables. The soldering station itself is a very small and light box with an OLED display, showing the current and the preset temperature of the soldering tip, the temperature of the station itself, and the current power usage. There's also a sleep function that automatically starts when there's 1 minute of inactivity. The time when the soldering station goes into sleep mode can be adjusted. The ELE-T12 has some advantages and disadvantages. An advantage is that the station uses an active tip so that the tip heats up very quickly and is also kept very stable at the desired temperature, so soldering will go better. An active tip is able to do this because it has an integrated heat element and a temperature sensor, which enables the active tip to transfer the heat better. The active tips used by the station are, in comparison to other brands, cheaper. There are also many different T12 tips, so there is plenty of choice. Another advantage is that the station is small and compact, but that is also the disadvantage, because that makes the station very light, which can cause the station to move while soldering. However, the soldering iron holder is a lot heavier, so that one cannot be moved too easily. A small disadvantage, however, is that the rotary button must be pushed very shortly or long enough when you're in the menu, otherwise the pressing of the button will not be recognized by the station. On the other hand, a big advantage is that the soldering station is a lot cheaper than other soldering stations. In comparison, this Hakka soldering station uses a passive tip and is even more expensive. Compared to other active soldering stations, for example, this JBC soldering station is much more expensive than the ELE-T12. In conclusion, based on the price and the active tip, I highly recommend this active soldering station. And I want to thank you for watching and hopefully I'll see you at the next video. Subscribe and like, and if you want to see more, click on the videos next to me.